YouTube, what's going on? It's Mesa Sean back at it with some Destiny 2. All right, folks, in this video, I'm going to show you a huge shortcut to save yourself a lot of time to getting to the final boss fight, where you need to defeat three bosses to get yourself the Whisper of Worm, or as we used to like to call it from Destiny 1, Black Spindle, or actually, this is more like Black Hammer, to be frank. So if you're watching this video, I'm going to assume that you know how to do this, right? It's a time, well, we think it's a timed thing over on Io, where you wait for a public event, you wait for one of these yellow bars to come out, you kill them, a portal opens up, and you go into this huge, like, it's almost like a mini raid, mini strike thing, where you get to this final room that you're seeing right now, and you gotta kill three bosses. So for a full guide, I believe Datto just put up a video. I don't know. I haven't been on YouTube all day. We've been literally grinding this all day until one of my moderators on the Destiny PS4 Facebook community that I founded sent me a link to a video posted by Jonathan Duff. I'm going to link both of them, well, if you have Facebook, in the description. They're the ones that showed this to me. And it's a shortcut that you have to, well, you basically will bypass this huge, well, kind of tedious jumping puzzle that we were struggling with for a long time. And once he showed us this shortcut, we burned through this thing. And we got to the final room with like 4 or 5 minutes on it. And we wasted everything. And we got our Black Spindles. Yeah, I don't know if I could call this thing Whisper of Worm. I'm calling it Black Spindle. Now, a big shout out to my friends Anthony and Danny. We spent all day doing this. And if you were curious about our loadouts, we pretty much went with 2 Sleeper Simulants and 1 Wardcliff Coil. Anthony was using the Wardcliff Coil for some ad control, and all of us went as Arcstriders. Now, I went with Arcstrider specifically for ad control, also for doing DPS on bosses, but also I went on the Hunter because I am terrible at jumping, and that's why I'm going to show you this shortcut here. But the Hunter, in my opinion, with the good old Stompies, makes it a lot easier to get through some of the jumping parts. So let me show you the shortcut now. So here's the main room that we were struggling with a lot because of the jumping, especially when I was on my Warlock. I said, I'm going with the Hunter with the Stompies. So you come to this main room here, and first off, they play some amazing music in here. But where I'm shooting right now, you got to get up there and start jumping and basically do a clockwise rotation all the way up there, all the way across. And this thing eats up so much time. If you fall down once, you got to start all over again. And we kept making it to the final boss, but with only a couple of minutes left. So we tested it a few times, and Anthony is the ultimate jumper. And he made it to the first section of ads that you need to kill, because there's basically 3 rooms that starts off this whole fight. And he made it there with 16 minutes left. So you could shave off so much time, get to the final room, have plenty of time to clear all the ads, and then kill all 3 bosses. There's Anthony up right there right now trying to get up there, and he's going to fall, and then you got to start it all over again. All right, enough, Sean. Show us the shortcut. Here's the shortcut. As soon as you go into the main room, instead of going left and doing the jumping puzzle, you're going to drop down right where I am right now, and you're going to see Anthony go into this little hole right there. You jump there, then you crouch, and then your ghost is going to light up for you, and you literally are just going to keep staying to your right, and you are going to bypass this entire jumping puzzle. And yeah, you're going to be there in 2 shakes of a lamb's tail. I know I've used that quote quite many times. What movie is that from? Let me know in the comments section. Yes, you're going to drop down here, and then I'm going to follow him. He actually thought I was behind him at this point. Drop down. You're going to turn right. There is a hole right there that you could fall down, and there's going to be another hole to the left. But here, just watch. I'm going to follow him. We're going to break right, and then we're brought to a section that would be right after that big, long jumping puzzle. So do this, guys. You will save yourself so much time, and you can get to the final boss with plenty of time. Once you finish it and you get your Black Spindle, no, I'm not calling it the new name, you unlock the heroic version of it. Now, the heroic version, we tried it once, and man, you get killed, just insta-killed by everything. So we might try it tomorrow. I still haven't done the prestige raid lairs yet, so I think I'm going to tackle that tomorrow night before we tackle heroic. So anyway, if you found this video helpful, do me a favor and leave me a like, but also leave me a hashtag made it to the end if you did make it to the end, and do me a favor, drop a like in this video only if you see fit. Follow me on the Twitter at Mesa Sean. Check out my stream, usually and always on YouTube, and that is it. I am out of here like Vladimir, and right here, yeah, this is where the first fight would be. And by the way, I switched to Raid and Flux after I was using the Stompies for the jumping, but then once you begin the fight, switch to your Raiden Flux. So this way you have you kill as many ads as possible, because when you have Arcstrider on with Raiden Flux, your super will last forever. All right, that's it, guys. See ya.